Walk in wisdom toward outsiders. Don't run away from them. Walk toward them. And then walk in wisdom. Say, I don't have much wisdom. Simple solution. Ask God for wisdom. By the way, there are outsiders all around your life. I love the word outsider because the message of Jesus is for outsiders. The message of Jesus is for those who don't feel accepted, who aren't on the inside. You know, Jesus went for the outsiders. He went for fishermen and tax collectors and publicans and sinners and prostitutes and tax collectors. The people that nobody wanted to be around, Jesus went after them. And at your job and at your school, I guarantee you, there's people that nobody wants to be around. You go after them. You love them. You share the love of Jesus in your life with the people nobody else pays attention to. Because they're the ones that are going to be open to the gospel. It's the insiders that don't want it. It's the people who feel like they're good enough. The people that feel like they're special. The people that feel like they've made it. They're the people that are the hardest to reach. Not saying that God can't reach them, but sometimes we want to be so close to the insiders, we ignore the outsiders and we serve the Lord who became the ultimate outsider for us. Some of you got neighbors nobody talks to. You talk to them. Some of you got friends nobody talks to. You talk to them. Somebody got coworkers that everybody else talks about. You talk to them. And by the way, there are some people you don't want to talk to. And I'm talking about the people who want to do nothing more than just argue. And you know who they are in your life. There's a little thing inside of all of us that we just want to prove that we're right. So we fall for it every time and we get into the argument and the back and forth and nothing ever changes. Ignore those people, please. I give you permission. Jesus said, do not cast your pearls before swine. Do not give to dogs what is sacred. There are some people that just want to take your words and trample them. They just want to argue about creation and evolution, social issues. Ignore those topics. You tell them what Jesus has done for you. That's your message. The same Jesus who said, go into all the world and tell everybody, every creature the gospel. He also said that there's gonna be some people who don't wanna listen. So what you do is you shake off the dust of your feet and you move on because there's someone you might be ignoring because you're obsessed with trying to prove yourself correct to this person who just wants to argue. Let your speech always be gracious, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how to answer each person. A couple things I wanna take from this passage. Seasoned with salt. Seasoned. Sprinkle it. Don't douse it. You don't have to always talk about everything. How you doing? I'm blessed. Praise God. Hallelujah. No. Sprinkle. How you doing? Well, I'm moving along in sanctification through the Lord Jesus Christ, who has secured my atonement and justification before the throne room of heaven. I'm just waiting for the premillennial kingdom of God, for the return of Christ and the rapture. Are you ready for the rapture, by the way? Have you got the breastplate of righteousness on your soul? I'm just heading for that judgment seat of Christ, not the great white throne judgment, the judgment seat of Christ. Of course, the judgment seat of Christ is for sinners like you, but I'm going to the judgment seat of Christ and you're going through the right throne judgment. So if you return and repent of your sins, maybe God will have mercy on your soul. No. Sprinkle. A little salt goes a long way. And you just talk about what God has done in your life. You just use the words about what the Lord has done. Just write this down. Treat each person individually, not like everybody's the same, because people are different. Some people are going through a hardship and your words need to be gracious toward them. Some people have a completely different view of the world than you and you have to be gracious to them. You have to speak with grace. Ephesians 4:29, let no corrupting talk come out of your mouths, but only such as is for building up as fits the occasion that it may give grace to those who hear. You can't reflect the fake news diatribes of our culture. You'll get nowhere and you'll abdicate your opportunity to be a light in a dark place. Don't fall for it. You be the one that has the words coming out of your mouth that are building up. So that everybody works with you. They say, man, you're just always so positive. Why are you always complimenting other people? Why are you always, that's when you have those opportunities to talk about, here's what I know about me. I know who I am in Christ. And I'm telling you, you share the gospel like that, I'll tell you, you become a contagious Christ follower. People will want to follow you as you follow Christ.